Hello dear students, a very warm good morning to all of you and welcome back in our biology session. So in today's biology session we are going to start the next lesson from the 6th standard state board and the name of the lesson is the living world. Okay, so in this schedule this is the last lesson that we are going to discuss. What is the name of that? It is the living world. Okay, so in this the living world we are going to discuss about mostly the characteristics of living things. Okay, now what is meant by the characteristics of the living thing? As we know that in our surrounding there are the so many plants and the animals. Okay, so there are the some similarities and there are the some dissimilarities among the plants and the animals. Okay, but there are the certain features in the living organisms which makes them different from the non-living things. Okay, so there are the certain things, there are the certain features present in the living organism, those who are totally absent in the non-living organism, and that is the reason they are separated or they are different from the non-living things. And that features which are present in the living organisms only, that features are called as what? Characteristics of living things. Okay, there are that things or that features are called as characteristics of living things. So there are so many different characteristics of living things are there that we are going to see deeply one by one. So in today's video let's start the first characteristics of the living organism, that is nothing but what? Living things grow. Okay, so this same point you will get in the 6th standard CBSE textbook lesson number 9. Okay, lesson number 9, in that also you will get this same point, that is what? Characteristics of living things. Okay, so let's discuss the first one, that is what? Living things grow. So as we know, if there is a living thing, then each and every living thing is growing, whether it is plant, whether it is animal, or whether it is human being. Okay, so remind yourself, whenever you was in your first standard, that time you were your height was so short. Okay, but as your year passes, as you come up in the higher classes, your body is growing. Okay, your height grows, your body shape grows. Okay, so in this way growth means what? The increase in the size, shape and the structure of the body. Okay, if we will take one example of the newborn baby, the newborn baby is there, then it slowly started to grow, then it grows, then it becomes a child, then it becomes an adult person, then it is young one, then it is what? Old person. Okay, so see here it is a sub stage that we can see how the human being is growing. Okay, small baby is there, then you are becomes a child, then the adult person is there, then the old person. Okay, so in this way the growth is going on in the human being. Or in the human being, the growth is going on up till the age of 18 to 21 years. Okay, up till the age of the 18 to 21 years, the growth is going on in the human body. After a certain time, the growth in the size and the shape gets stopped. Okay, and after that year, your body is not growing. Okay, so growth is a very important characteristic in the living organism. Human beings are showing the growth. Also, animals are showing the growth. As we know, the puppy is there. Puppy is getting slowly converted into a dog. Kittens get slowly converted into the cat. So from the eggs, hen's eggs, the chick comes out. Okay, and that chicks get grown up and it slowly get converted into the rooster or in the hen. Okay, so in this way, animals are also showing the growth. Along with the animals, plants are also showing the growth, because the plants are also living things. As you know, if you sow the seed into the soil, then what will happen? This seed started to get germinate. Okay, this seed started to get germinate. Then slowly it forms a small plant. And then small plant get converted into slowly into a big tree. Okay, so in this way, what we can say that? The plants are also showing the growth. Okay, but there is one another thing in that plant. Some plants are showing the growth in a vertical manner. For example, we can say that coconut is there, also we can say the bamboo plant is there. And some plants are showing the growth in a horizontal manner. They are very big, like a banyan, पीपल ट्री. ओके, दे आर वेरी बिग. देयर हाइट एज कंपेयर टू कोकोनट एंड बैम्बू इज शॉर्ट, बट देयर विड्थ इज बिग. ओके, सो ग्रोथ इज नथिंग बट मीन्स वॉट, इंक्रीजिंग द हाइट एंड द विड्थ, वी कैन से दैट. सो इन दिस वे प्लांट्स आर ऑल्सो शोइंग द ग्रोथ. फॉर दैट पर्पज वी आर हैविंग वन एक्सपेरिमेंट. ओके, व्हाट इज दैट एक्सपेरिमेंट? सी हियर, वी हैव टेकन टू पॉटेड प्लांट्स. ओके, एंड इन दैट पॉटेड प्लांट्स वी हैव प्लांट वन ट्री और वी हैव प्लांट वन सीड्स. ओके, एंड वी हैव टाइड वन थ्रेड ओवर इट. दिस थ्रेड इज स्ट्रेच. ओके, दिस थ्रेड इज स्ट्रेच. ओके, we have to wait for 2 to 3 weeks. Okay, or we have to wait for the 10 to 15 days. Then what will happen? This same potted plant is started to grow. Okay, it grows into the height. Then because of that, what happens? This same stretch thread. This is what? Stretch thread. This is what? Stretch thread. So this stretch thread becomes, this stretch thread becomes loose. What is it so? Why is it happen? Because as the time passes, this sapling, this seedling, it started to grow into the height, and that is the reason this stretch thread is getting loose. Okay, this stretch thread is getting loose. Okay, so from this thing we can come to know that, or from this experiment we can come to know that what? The plants are also growing. There is a one more thing is that to measure the growth of the plant, we are having one instrument, and the name of that instrument is earth indicator. Okay, what is the name of that instrument? That is earth indicator. See here how is the exactly earth indicator. In the image you can see how it is exactly earth indicator. So with the help of that earth indicator, we can measure the growth of the growing plants. Okay, so say here plants can grow for the many more years, but the animals can grow for the certain age only. After that age, animals cannot grow, animals or human beings cannot grow. Okay, so this is about what the living things grow. This is the first characteristics of the living thing. Okay, so only the living things are showing the growth, non-living things are not showing the growth. For example, this board, as the year passes, this board will increase in a height or increase in a size? No. Why? Because this board is what? Non-living thing. Okay, now we move on to the next characteristics, that is food is necessary for growth. Okay, so as we know that food is necessary for the proper maintenance, repair of our body. Food is gives us energy, and that energy is get utilized for our growth. Okay, so in this way what we can say, that food is necessary for our growth. Plants, animals, human beings, all these living organisms require the food for their proper growth. Let's see. So as we know, the plants are there, or the green plants. Why they are green? Because they are having one colorful pigment in that. And what is the name of that colorful pigment? That is chlorophyll. Okay, what? Chlorophyll. So because of this presence of the chlorophyll, plants can make their own food in the presence of sunlight. Okay, so what the things used by the plant? Carbon dioxide plus water. In the presence of sunlight and chlorophyll, plants make their own food in the form of carbohydrates. Okay, in the form of carbohydrates, or you can say as what? Glucose. And also they release the oxygen gas. And the food making process in the plant is called as what? Photosynthesis. What? Photosynthesis. Okay, so since the food making process in the plant takes place in the sunlight, that is the reason it is called as what? Photosynthesis process. So with the help of the photosynthesis process, the plants can make their own food, and that is the reason plants are called as autotrophs.
Okay, the plants are called as what? Autotrophs. Now I will tell you what is mean by auto. Auto means what? Self. What is the word auto says? Auto means what? Self. And trophs means what? Nutrition. Trophs means what? Nutrition. So plants can fulfill their need of the nutrition by themselves. They are not depends on anyone for their food. They make their own food. That is the reason the plants are called as what? Autotrophs. Okay. And rest of the other all organisms, all animals are directly or indirectly depends on the plants for their food. They cannot mix their own food. For example, we can say that there are the some herbivores which eat the plants, and there are the some organisms, there are the some animals which eats the herbivores and fulfill their need of the food. For example, for that animals we are calling as what? Carnivores. Lion, tiger eats the deer. Okay. And in this way they fulfill their need of the food. Okay. So the plants can make their food by their own. That's why they are called as autotroph. And remaining all the organisms cannot make their own food by their own food for their food purpose. They are totally depends upon the plants. And that's why they are called as heterotrophs. Okay, they are called as heterotrophs. Okay, they are called as heterotrophs. Hetero means what? Other. Hetero means what? Other. And trophs means what? Nutrition. For them, nutrition that depends on the other. That's why they are called as what? Heterotrophs. Okay, two words are there, very important. Autotrophs, heterotrophs. Auto makes their own food. Heterotrophs depends on the other for their food. What is the example of the heterotrophs? All animals and including human beings also. Okay. And autotrophs means what? All green plant makes their own food. That's why they are what? Autotrophs. Okay. So this is about the second characteristics in the living organism. That is what? Food is necessary for growth. Now my dear students, we will move for the next one characteristics. Okay. So see, you have to take the screenshot and you have to write all these notes in your biology notebook. Okay. So you can take the screenshot and now I can rub the board. So now here we are going to move for the next one. Okay. We are going to move for the next one characteristics, that is giving him respite. Okay, which is very important also. So as you know, throughout our life, okay, throughout our life we are doing the, or we are taking inside oxygen and we are releasing carbon dioxide. Okay, so the taking inside oxygen and releasing out carbon dioxide, that process is called as breathing. That process is called as what? Breathing. Okay, so taking inside oxygen and throwing it out carbon dioxide, that process is called as breathing. So without breathing we can survive? No, obviously no. We cannot survive for the few minutes also without doing the breathing process. So very important thing is that intake of oxygen and exhale of carbon dioxide. This process is called as what? Breathing. Again I will repeat, taking inside oxygen and throwing outside carbon dioxide, this process is called as breathing. Okay, this process is called as breathing. So different organisms are having different organs to do the breathing process. For example, we can say that the green plant or the leaves are having tiny pores on it and they are called as what? Stomata. So with the help of the stomata, plants are doing the breathing process. Next one, animals like lion, tiger, human being, okay, all these are the animals, those who are doing the breathing with their lungs, okay. Next one is there, as you know, there are some insects are there, and on the body of the insect there are some tiny holes are there. So with the help of that tiny holes, they are doing the breathing, which are called as what? Spiracles. Which are called as what? Spiracles. Next one is their fish. Fish is having the gills to do the breathing. Okay, to do the breathing. Fish is taking the oxygen, which is dissolved in air, which is dissolved in water. So they take the water inside. That gills absorbs the oxygen from the water, and excessive water they are throwing out from the body with the help of the gills only. Okay. So some animals breathe with the lungs. For example, human being, lion, tiger, giraffe, zebra, all that. Next one, insects do the breathing with the spiracles. Fish do the breathing with the gills, and plants are doing the breathing process with the help of the stomata. Aquatic plants are also there. So that aquatic plants can do the breathing. They are taking the oxygen which is dissolved in the water. Okay, so this is about the breathing. How the plants are, which organs the plant animals are using, and the plants is using for the breathing purpose. But after the breathing, what happens with that oxygen which we take inside? Okay, so the oxygen which we take inside during the breathing process, that oxygen is get utilized by our body, is get used by our body to break down the food, to break down the food and to release the energy. Okay, so this oxygen is get utilized for what purpose? For what work oxygen is get used? So whatever the food we are having, that food goes in our body, get digest, but it is very complex form. It needs to make it into the simple form. It needs to break it. Okay, and who helps to break that food? Oxygen that we have taken during the breathing process. Okay, so the oxygen is get utilized to break the food, and after that, what happens? Breaking of the food, it releases the energy and water. It releases the energy and the water. Okay, and also it throws out the carbon dioxide. Also, it throws out the carbon dioxide. Okay, so intake of the oxygen will, and this process is called as what? Respiration. That process is called as what? Respiration. Okay, this process is called as respiration. Again, I will discuss the definition of the respiration. So the respiration is the process which takes place in the body of an organism. In that what happens, the oxygen is get utilized to break down the food and to release the energy, water and carbon dioxide. Energy, water and carbon dioxide. Okay, so this process is called as what? Respiration. Okay, see, breathing and respiration, both are little bit different. Breathing just intake of oxygen and exhale of carbon dioxide. But that oxygen is get utilized to break the food. After breaking down of the food, what release out? Energy, water and carbon dioxide. Okay, so we are throwing out when we exhale. Okay, when we breathe out, we are throwing the carbon dioxide. Also, some energy get produced in our body, and that energy we are using to perform the different work. Okay, and also we are throwing out the water. As we know, if we'll breathe near to the glass, then we can see the water vapor. Okay, that is only what water we are throwing during the breathe out. Okay, and that process is called as what? Respiration. Okay, so see, I will write here equation of the respiration. What is the equation? Food plus oxygen, which is that process, that is what? Respiration. Okay, so what it releases? It releases carbon dioxide plus water plus energy. Okay, carbon dioxide plus water plus energy. So in this way, this is the respiration process takes place in our body, only in the living organism's body. Okay, so it is a very important characteristic, that is what the living things respire. Okay, so these are the three characteristics that today we have discussed, that are living things grow, food is necessary for growth, and living things respire. Okay, so
So this is all about today. Today we will stop here. You have to see the video properly. Also try to write the notes from the video. Okay, so this is all about today. Today we will stop here. We'll meet in the next video with the next point. And for today, thank you.